This is a Squiz Kids podcast. Your fresh take on what's happening in the world around you.
It's a religious celebration with candles, games, yummy food, and sometimes presents. And no, we are not talking about Christmas. This is your Squiz Kids shortcut to Hanukkah, the podcast where we dive into the who, what, when, where, why, and how of the big news stories. I'm Amanda Bauer.
And I'm Bryce Corbett.
Now, Bryce, I know that you have been counting down the days until Christmas on the podcast.
Oh, yeah. I love Christmas. Cannot wait.
Well, try not to get too jealous when I tell you that Hanukkah, which many people think of as the Jewish alternative to Christmas, starts earlier on December 19 and lasts until December 26.
What? 8 whole days? Today, we'll take you through what Hanukkah is, how it's celebrated, and why it's celebrated at a different time each year.
Listen carefully. There's a squiz at the end.
What?
The Hebrew word Hanukkah means dedication, and to explain what it is, we're going to need to fire up the old Squiz Kids time machine.
Cool.
We're heading back. I'm talking 2,200 years back. Whoa. To Jerusalem, yeah. A city in the Middle East that is a holy place for Jews. At the time that we've travelled to, the Greek king Antiochus IV Epiphanes,
good name,
with the help of his mighty army, was ruling over Jerusalem.
Mm-hmm.
And he was forcing local people to adopt the Greek culture and religion.
Yep.
But then came the rebellion. Oh. A small band of Jews, the Maccabees, fought the Greek army and drove them out of Jerusalem.
So is the dedication of Hanukkah talking about how dedicated those Jewish fighters were?
Well, no. It actually refers to one of the first things that the Maccabees did once they got rid of the Greeks.
Okay.
They went to what is called the Second Temple in Jerusalem. A temple is a house of worship, like mm-hmm. a church or a mosque is. And they rededicated it to the Jewish God. That right. was because the Greeks had destroyed many things in the temple and they'd put up a statue of one of their own gods, Zeus.
By the gods!
Ah, and what did the rededication involve?
Well, they cleaned the temple, they installed a new altar, and they lit the menorah.
Aha, and a menorah is a special kind of candlestick mentioned in the Old Testament of the Bible and in Jewish holy books.
You got it.
It holds 7 different candles, is that right?
Well, it either holds candles or little oil lamps. And I know that makes it sound like I'm being really finicky, Bryce, but the right. reason I'm mentioning that is that the miracle of the oil is something that's really important to Hanukkah.
Okay.
So the story goes that when the Maccabees first entered the Second Temple, they found one remaining jar of pure oil for the menorah.
Right.
Now, that jar should have only lasted for one day,
mm-hmm.
but the menorah kept burning for 8 straight days until more pure oil could be produced.
Aha! The lamp was lit at the dedication, called the Hanukkah, and it burned for 8 days, and the celebration, therefore, of Hanukkah lasts 8 days.
You got it. Although Jewish scholars love to debate. So some of them argue that if the oil was meant to last one day, then only 7 of the days were really miracles.
I love it.
But still, there is no doubt that lighting the menorah is the most important religious aspect of Hanukkah today.
Mm-hmm.
Let's talk about how Hanukkah is celebrated.
How?
So, Bryce, Jewish families often have 2 menorahs, an mm-hmm. everyday one that holds 7 candles and a special Hanukkah one that holds 9.
Ah.
So one candle is called the Shamash, or the Helper, and it's used to light the others.
Right.
On the first night of Hanukkah, you light the first candle. On the second night, you light that first one plus one more.
Yeah.
And so on until the last night when all 8 plus the Shamash are blazing.
Oh, and what do people do once they've lit the menorah?
Well, in keeping with the oil theme of the miracle of the oil, they often eat fried food okay. fried in oil.
Yeah.
So I'll put a link in your episode notes to a recipe for latkes, which are fried potato pancakes.
Mm.
They are served either with applesauce or sour cream.
Okay.
I highly recommend the sour cream.
Yeah.
And in Israel, which is considered the Jewish homeland, people prefer sufganiyot, which are jelly-filled donuts. So I'll throw that recipe in for free too.
Now that's... sounds like my cup of tea.
Now, a common game played by kids during Hanukkah uses a four-sided spinning top called a dreidel,
yeah,
which has a Hebrew letter on each side.
Mm-hmm.
Those four letters stand for the Hebrew phrase that means a great miracle happened here, referring mm-hmm. again to that miracle of the oil.
Yep.
It's actually a pretty fun game, so I've put a link in your episode notes for a way to make your own dreidel and then to play the game.
Okay, and you mentioned that presents were sometimes involved?
Yeah, well, the tradition is to give kids something called Hanukkah Geld. Geld means money.
Oh.
The idea was that this would allow children to pay some of the money forward and donate it to charity.
Okay.
But because presents are so important to most people's celebrations of Christmas, and Hanukkah happens close to Christmas, it's not uncommon nowadays for Jewish kids to get 8 presents, one for each day of Hanukkah.
I'm glad you brought up the timing of Hanukkah. Why is it celebrated on a different date each year?
Why?
Well, Judaism has a different calendar from the calendar that's used in most parts of the world.
Okay.
So that one, the one that we use, is called the Gregorian calendar.
Yep.
And right now in the Gregorian calendar, we are in the year 2022.
Mm-hmm.
On the Jewish calendar, we are in the year 5783.
Okay.
Which began at sunset on September 25th this year and will end at sunset on September 15, 2023.
Ah, and because the Jewish year lasts less than 365 days, Hanukkah starts on different days on our calendar.
Yeah, that's right. So it always starts on the evening of Kislev 25th on the Jewish calendar. Kislev is a month that occurs around November and December on our calendar.
Okay.
And sometimes it's known as the month of dreams.
Oh, candles, fried food, games. Sounds like the stuff of dreams to me.
I see what you did there.
Time for the quiz.
This is the part of the podcast where you get to test how well you've been listening. Question number one. What's the name for the special candlestick that is a symbol of the Jewish religion? Yeah, that's right. It's called the menorah.
Question number two. What does the word Hanukkah mean? Well done, you are a dedicated listener. If you got that, it is dedication.
Question number three, this will test you. The Maccabees defeated the Greek army and then dedicated or rededicated a temple in which city? Yeah, that's right. Well done for you listening. It was Jerusalem.
That's all we have time for today. Thanks for joining us as we explored the who, what, how, where, when, and why of Hanukkah.
Now get out there and have a most excellent day.
Over and out. These episodes are edited and engineered by Carter Quinn. We are guessing that you're feeling a whole lot more knowledgeable after diving into that Squiz Kids shortcut. Don't forget, every Monday, all through the holidays, we'll dive into the who, what, when, where, why, and how of another big topic. Then on Wednesdays, the Squiz Kids Superfast Supersonic Jetliner will take off to explore a new country every week along with its culture. And on Saturdays, Bryce will be challenging you and your grown-ups to a kids versus adults quiz on a different topic every week. And all of this amazing content is absolutely free. It's our little gift to you this festive season. And if you just can't get enough, don't forget about NewsHounds, our brand new media literacy program for primary school kids. Your chance to join Squizzy the NewsHound as he sniffs out the truth on the internet. If you're keen to know more, head to www.squizkids.com.au. And of course, if this is the first time you've come across us, Squiz Kids Today is a free daily news podcast during the school term, a kid-friendly take on the big news headlines, and we're available wherever you get your podcasts or on our website, squizkids.com.au.